data interpretation a la Shmoop. You and your best friend do everything together. Let's face it, you two are pretty much attached at the hip. It's becoming complicated though, because you're starting to get a little better at things than your BFF. You won the cookie eating contest, you beat them in the potato sack race, you were able to swim all the way across the lake. So how much can you two still be friends if you're so much better at everything than they are? The answer? Data interpretation. In the world of pre-algebra, and in many other mathematical worlds as well, data interpretation is the expression and analysis of data that you've collected. A couple of common tools used to interpret information and express data are bar graphs and pie charts. Let's revisit the infamous cookie-eating contest of last December and make a bar graph of the results over the course of time. As you'll recall, the goal was to eat 25 Chips Ahoy cookies as quickly as possible. So yeah, you won. But let's interpret this data with a bar graph for you and one for your friend to see how we might be able to give your friend some cookie-eating cred. Well, let's break the bars into chunks of time. The first bar will be cookies consumed from start to minute 2. The second bar will be cookies consumed from minute 2 to minute 4, and so on and so forth. So let's look at the two graphs side by side. Is there any way we can make your friend the hero in this case? Well, as it turns out, your friend is actually a sprinter in the cookie consuming department. He ate 8 cookies in the first 2 minutes while you only ate 5. Of course, you did come back for the win, but we definitely think his speedy consumption is deserving of a shout out. So if you feel like you are always winning or always losing, remember, there are different ways to interpret the data from any particular event, and sometimes the interpretation may turn you from a loser into a wiener.